May I have your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen? We have the first presenter of the afternoon now, Zubeda Bhai, who's the overall winner of the first India-Africa Business Venture Competition, studied initially at India and currently doing research work at the University of Colorado. So Zubeda will take you through a brief presentation on her winning business venture.
Thank you, Amit. Good afternoon, everybody. Can I have your quick attention, please? My name is Zubeda Bhai, and I'm the founder and CEO of a new venture about a year old called EYES. And we are in the business of saving lives. Now, before I start into this presentation and tell you more about the business and what I do, let me get your attention by asking all of you a simple question. How many of you in this room have children or know people who have children? That's a good crowd. I know people are listening. I can bet that none of you would have ever thought about losing the mother or the baby at the time of childbirth. Okay, so however, in the same world that we live in, we lose mothers and babies approximately equal to 1 million in number just between India and Africa every single year, only due to unclean, unsterile conditions at the time of childbirth. Even today in countries like India and Africa, newborn babies lose their lives. Not because they want to die, but because any closest, sharpest object can be used in the process of childbirth. Go to the nearest healthcare situation. This is something similar that they can find themselves into. Dust, flies, bloodstains are a constant nuisance, despite the fact that the government is trying hard to make these conditions better. The volume of births that's happening, just between India and Africa, I would say about 30 million births happening every year, does not permit the situation to get better. So what do we do as a business of saving lives? We've introduced our first product called Janma, which is a $2 clean birth kit that not only comes in a beautiful biodegradable bag with culturally appropriate colors, but also contains in it the 6 simple tools that the World Health Organization recommends to prevent infections, mortality, and morbidity at the time of childbirth. We started as a small company in southern India about a year and a half ago, hoping to save mothers and babies in the state of Tamil Nadu. Very soon, we realized that we've started selling our kits in more than 6-7 states in India and 5 countries in Africa, and we realized that the need is growing enormously. We have about 20,000 kits sold with absolutely no marketing efforts, team of 2 people last year, and we have orders of about 50,000 kits this year pre-standing. So we've raised our first round of investment, we've grown to a team of 8, and right now we are in the business of saving lives going forward. Now, what's the biggest problem in India that we find is that the healthcare system is not black or white. It's not plain vanilla, just like we would go to a healthcare institution in the US and there you go. But there's different sectors, different kind of healthcare clinics, starting from a small clinic in a village where a woman goes to a midwife and gets delivered at home, to like the largest healthcare institution, which is private, to government hospitals. So it's taken us a while to figure out how this healthcare system works. But now that we've figured out and established a strong distribution system, we've also introduced our second product, which is a newborn kit that can save lives of newborns and prevent infections there. And we hope that through this channel, we will introduce many more products to prevent maternal mortality and morbidity and impact lives and sell about 5 million products in the next 5 years, impact lives of about 24 million people. And not only that, through our innovative packaging mechanisms, we also hope to reduce about 2 million pounds of plastic from going into the landfill. To add really good topping to that really nice cake, we also employ local women whom we provide livelihood opportunities to by assembling our products in local rural Indian villages. Now, of course, everything sounds nice. Do we have competition? Yes, we do. This is our huge competition that is actually being given away for free in the Indian and African markets through international NGOs. It's a razor blade that men use for shaving, a little piece of thread, a soap, and a plastic sheet. The standard of care can be improved at as low as $2 a piece. And Katie is holding it there if you want to look at the product. The other big problem that we face is lack of awareness. Just because it sounds like a very simple issue, but it is a killer. That being said, we have a strong team and a board of advisors that are helping us to take this business forward. It's me. I'm a mechanical engineer by profession. I have an MBA in social and sustainable enterprises, and I have 2 co-founders with me who helped me found the company. And we also have a strong board of advisors from organizations like Harvard, MIT, seasoned social entrepreneurs in India as well. We've also, over the last year, made a lot of international and national partners that help us do sales in the developing world. And finally, I just want to leave you with three thoughts, that we are in the business of saving lives, and we are selling really low-cost products that can help mothers and babies survive. And we exist as a commitment to save lives and change lives, one woman, one product, one happy woman at a time. Thank you.